Welcome back. Okay. And it is the next day. The pottery has finished. And the clay bricks, well, the mud bricks, are still wet. So by the end of this episode, hopefully. Well, at the end of this first day of this episode, that'll be all good. Now, the way we pick these up is we have an empty hand. We shift right click. There's a second way to do it, which really is a lot faster. You just punch it. And it all pops up. So let's go show you what the ceramic jugs do. You right click on fresh water and you get water. You hold down right click and you drink. It's a lot faster. As far as the ceramic vessels, they're very useful because they slow down the decay of things like food. Only problem is you can't put an item that's more than 80 ounces in because that'll have a different size profile. If you notice, on here my onion has the a medium weight and medium size. So what we can do is we can pop it in here with our knife, and all of a sudden it's lightweight and small. We can do the same thing in for the steak. Lightweight and small. Want to split it that much. You can also combine them back too. And we'll just store some of our food in there. Once again, that'll decay a lot less. Now, as far as the bowls are concerned, there's really two uses for it. One, you can stick it up here and pull out a gold pan. I'll show you all about that in a little bit. But for right now, I'm going to talk about the other use. For that, we're going to need a stone knife and a ceramic bowl. And a place to put it. So, yeah, I think a nice hickory log would be just fine for that. And our fire is here, so, you know, yeah, let's put it right here. I don't think that'll catch fire. It might, but I don't think it will. Then you just take your knife and you right click on the top. And then all of a sudden, you have bowls in here. And what we can do with this is we can make sandwiches, which require a piece of bread and then four ingredients. Important thing to note that the ingredients do have to be different, not just different forms of the same thing. So, like, if you had four different forms of cooked cherries. You couldn't just put that in there. It wouldn't work because they're still cherries. But if you had bread and cooked venison, onion, or and cherries, that would work. Or even cherries and oranges. You can still have two fruits, just not two of the same item. Can also make salads with them too. Important thing to note is the numbers up on top here, what they actually stand for is how many ounces they're going to use. So take for instance, if we wanted to reduce this down to a size where we could store it, we could use it as the main ingredient, which would take 10 ounces. And if we do that 3 times, we'd have like 79 ounces, and then it could fit in the ceramic vessel. So it's very good to alternate which one's there, so that you get the right size to go back in your vessels. Right now, we're not going to really take that much advantage of it. We'll take more advantage of it later. You should probably get these fruit tree saplings planted though. With that being said, thinking I'm gonna make another item in here too. Yeah, I definitely think I'm gonna do that. Also gonna take some of this and make a foundation for myself. So where should we put these fruit trees? Actually, this looks pretty good. Allowing a part for the sapling and the leaves to come off of it. And then we plant it, it'll grow over time. We really don't need to do this part right here, but it'll make it a little easier for us. Okay, there we go. You know what I didn't realize? I was probably gonna reuse this pit kiln, so maybe that's not the best place to do this. So let's just punch it off. It won't be that big of an issue. We still get our bowl back, and then we can just use our axe to pick this up and move it. Yeah, let's just put it here. Now the next item, what we're gonna basically do is just dig out all this clay in the center. And we'll get a large vessel. And these have to be cooked by themselves. Okay, these are now nice and dry. And you know, I'm thinking I'm going to... I don't know. I don't really know where I'm gonna put my first house, actually. That's quite a bit of a fall. I guess we could put it like right here. Kind of like, looks like a nice spot. Yeah, I kinda like it. Okay, and we are just going to sleep the night out. Well, more of huddle the night out. And I will see you in the morning. And we are back. While we were waiting out the night, I just went ahead and made some shovels. Well, a shovel at least. That will be the base blueprint for the house. Where did I put those logs? They're there. Now, I don't know how high I want it yet, so for the time being, I'm just gonna place these. I do know that I'm gonna want this and the other tree at the other end be cut down. Thinking that we're gonna have an offset door. That will be where the doors can go. And then what we can do with these mud bricks is we can lay them out in a crafting grid like this. And then we have these to work with. Not sure if I want that as a solid or not. I mean, there's not much to look at if it's... Yeah, you know what? Let's have that as a solid. Just because there is not much to look at there. And can we punch these? So yes, we can punch these. Okay, cool. It's looking decent. It's a bit too dark, but I don't know. Yeah, I think it would be worse if we used the sequoia there. Let's find out. I know for a fact we're gonna need a new axe for this one though. And we're probably gonna want to free up some space. Actually, is that a whole cave down there? You know, I think it is. We might have to actually go explore that later. Meantime, let's make the profile of the walls a little bit smaller so we don't accidentally fall down there. So let's cut down our first sequoia. Unlike other mods that allow you to chop down the whole tree, this one takes a bit of durability for every block that's in it. So, with me having just like a little bit of durability on that axe, it's not gonna cut it. It will remove the logs that it can remove, but it will not remove any more than it can. As you can see, we still have quite a bit of tree left. So let's go ahead and grab ourselves a couple more axes. And I know it doesn't look like it's actually removing, but it really is. It's just sequoia trees are, quite frankly, that large. Let's see how much wood we got out of just one sequoia tree. 32, 64, so we got 96, and yeah, I'd say we got a fair amount there, because that's 100, then that's 123. We got 123 logs out of that. One tree. Actually, you know what? I think the hickory, although it looks nice, it's too small of a contrast. Yeah, it's too small of a contrast. I think I'm gonna use the sequoia on it. We'll find something else to use the hickory on later. So I'm just basically going to pull these beams out and replace them with these, and I will be back in a minute. And we're back. Yeah, I think it looks a lot better with that. I went ahead and removed those. As far as windows, we need to decide whether or not we want large windows or small. So let's go get ourselves something to stand on by the window. You know what? Yeah, let's make large windows. It's gonna take a little bit more supplies to make the actual house, but I think we can do it. Okay. And then let's just go ahead and fill in some of these empty spots that we don't have supplies for yet with thatch. It's a very temporary fix. Yeah, why not? We'll use this as a temporary door. We don't quite have walls where we want to have a torch, so just place one there and one opposite here. We don't really need these. Okay, and I will wait out the night, and I will see you later. And we are back. All I did was move the kitchen table inside. And let's go check up on this. Okay, there we go. It is done. Where would be a good place for this? I'd put it in front, but I'm gonna have a little overhead here, so I wanted to have sky access. So I'm thinking maybe putting it here. Yeah. Meantime, let's go get some water. Oh, I forgot to tell you, if you right click with a large vessel on water, it fills up with water. And then what you can do is you can just it'll say that you're overburdened because it's heavy. Just move it onto your back slot here. Place it down. And there you go. I think what we're gonna do here is actually, you know what? Yeah, let's just turn all of it into it. I don't know how much it's gonna take. Would that do it? No. That nope. Just start trying some even numbers. Okay, there we go. And now we have 5,000 millibuckets of lime water. So what we can do is we can put our hides in here. Oh, you know, I wanted one of these for making a map if we ever find a squid. So we can put our hide in here. If we get another one of these, we can also start getting a little leather tanning process going on over here. I think what we need to do, we need to loosen up the fibers, scrape them off on the top of this log, and I think we need to soak off the stuff we scraped and then treat it. So we're gonna need two more of those vessels. And you've already seen how this works, and you've seen how I collect clay, so I'm probably gonna save a lot of that for off camera. All I'm basically going to do with here is just fill up the top with thatch until I get a chance to get enough clay and straw. and dirt to otherwise fill that in. I have some dirt, but it's not gonna be enough. All that I can do off camera. Let's show you the gold pan. I've not shown you the gold pan yet. Now you could do this in any moving water, but I like to do it by the ocean. That way I don't have to worry about the current nearly as much. So what you do is you just get some moving water and you fill up your gold pan with some dirt or sand or gravel. And you just hold down right click on the moving water. You cannot use blocks that are underneath the water. You actually have to click on the top that has air access. After a while, the blocks will get exhausted and they will go away. It's not the best way to find resources by any stretch of the imagination, but it does work. At least it should. Watch you prove me a liar. And I think I'm just gonna, it's more of the same thing, so I'm gonna cut here and I'll come back when I find something. Okay, and I got my first piece. It's a platinum nugget. You can see how much it took. It also has a chance of getting me copper. And as you start advancing through your prospecting skill, you'll have better chances of finding things like gold and silver. So if you find an absolute block and you cannot find any gold, or you can't find any silver at all, but you need it for like an alloy or recipe, this is one way that you can get a guaranteed chance to find it. Just actually finding it in here will take a lot of time. So with that being said, I'm gonna do an awful lot of this and more of the things that I showed you, and I'm thinking I'm going to see you next episode. So until then, I will talk to you later.